Hey everyone, in this video we're going to talk about the normal curve and z-scores, and we're just going to kind of do the basics of the normal curve and then using the table from the book to look up areas and z-scores from there. So I'm starting with just basic properties of the standard normal curve. This is kind of what it looks like here. We've talked a little bit about this before. The normal curve is our bell curve shape, so it represents a distribution of data. In the standard normal curve, the standard is always centered at zero. And we can think about zero here as being the mean. So our data is centered around that, and then it sort of tapers off in both directions. We're thinking of the standard deviation of this normal curve as being 1. So remember we talked about z-scores. Z equals 0 is right in the middle. And then as we move away, we're getting z equals 1, z equals 2, z equals 3, and then in the negative direction we have negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Now in this picture here, I just hand drew this, so this is probably not particularly accurate. In a real normal curve, most of the data is going to be clumped right here in the middle, right around the mean. And if you go, for example, 2 or 3 standard deviations above or below, there's going to be very few data values out here, so the graph really kind of tapers off. Now, theoretically speaking, no matter how far we go out to the right or to the left, there would still be some data values, but the probability of finding one of those becomes exceedingly small. In most cases, we're not even really going to care about values beyond about 3 standard deviations. The next really important property of the normal curve is that the area underneath it represents sort of a percentage or a probability. If we're talking about data, we're looking at the percentage of data that falls into that range. Now, if we look at the entire curve, that would be all of the data, which means that it would be 100% or a probability of 1. So all the area underneath, everything shaded underneath, would be an area of 1. And the area is going to represent a probability or a percentage. And in this video, we're going to be looking at how to find that area or how to find that percentage. In the next video, we'll look a little bit more at some applications of what we would do with that information. So we just looked at the standard normal curve. Generally, our normal curves do not start, or they are not centered at zero. They're centered around the mean of our data. So whatever that average value is, that's the center of our data. So imagine if you had test scores, right? The average on the test would be right in the center. Typically wouldn't be zero. And then if we move to each side, right, again this represents a z-score of 0. If I move over by 1 standard deviation, either sigma or s depending upon whether we're talking about a sample or a population, this would be z equals 1. Our z equals 2 would be 2 standard deviations away. And then same thing if we move in the negative direction, we have z equals negative 1, z equals negative 2. The shape is going to be the same, but we will have to make some adjustments for non-standard curves. And we're going to address this in the next video. Okay, so there's 2 components that we want to be able to do in this section here. The first is finding the area underneath our curve using a z-score. So here we're told our z-score is 0.67. This is just to the right of the center, right? Remember, the center would be at 0. And we want to know what this area would be. Now, I really want you guys to draw these when you're doing your homework problems so that you can have an estimate of what this would be. Now, since we have a little bit more than half of the area shaded, I'm looking for something more than 0.5. Remember, the whole area is 1. Now, I'm going to get these areas from table A2 in our book. This is on that sort of cardboard pullout that's in the book. You can find tables like this on the internet. You can find it in the appendix, lots of different places. You can also get these values from the calculator, but I personally like to use the table, so that's what I'm going to do in this video. If you want to use the calculator, that is fine with me. So here is the table in our appendix. You'll see that there are actually separate tables for the positive z-scores and the negative z-scores. So this is in our book. Again, many other books will have similar tables. Now our z-score in this case is positive. We were dealing with a z-score of 0.67. So we're going to look in this table, starting in this column for z, we're looking at 0.6, so that would put us here. And for the second digit, you have to follow along on the top here. So for 0.67, we're going to go to the 0.6 row and follow over until we're underneath 0.07. So this spot right here aligns for 0.67. Now this tells us that the area is 0.7486. Right, now that's the answer to our question here. Again, make sure you're checking to make sure that that makes sense to you. Visually speaking, we were guessing a number more than 0.5. 0.74 sounds about right. Now we don't know exactly. Again, this is just a very loose sketch that I did, but we should say, okay, that's a reasonable answer. Next question, we've got a negative z-score, so we're looking for that area on the left. This should be a fairly small area. This has got to be less than 0.5, probably by quite a bit, but it's a little bit hard to tell. So I'm going to go to my table. Now we're going to have to go to the negative z-scores list, that other page, and we're looking at the negative z-score for our problem. Now I do want to point out here, this table is always giving you the area to the left of our z-score. Now that's what we want in this case, but we're going to look at something else in the next problem. So we had a z-score of negative 1.5, so I'm going to scroll down. We're looking for negative 1.5. Now in this case there wasn't any extra decimal, so I'm going to use that first column, which really is 0, 0, so no extra decimal places. So a z-score of negative 1.5, we're getting an area 0.0668. Okay. This is a pretty small area. Again, these areas really represent probabilities or percentages. We could think of this as a probability of 0.07 or about 7%. And the way you want to think of this is that if we're talking about data values here, there's about 7% of the data that falls below or to the left of a z-score of negative 1.5. Alright, next one, we have a z-score of 2.01. So this is a positive z-score. We're going to use our positive chart, but notice that the area we want is the area to the right. Now, the area that we're going to get from the table is going to be to the left. So we're first going to look that up in the table, 2.01. So I'm on my positive z-scores page. 2.01 is our 2.0, and then I have to go 1 over for a 0.1 value, 0.9778. So that is the area to the left of the z-score 2.01. Now the area that we actually want is this area over here. So we're going to have to use our knowledge of the whole graph, right? Remember, the whole area is 1. So if we want this other side, we're going to do 1 minus 0.9778, and this is going to give us the blue area here. So the area we want is 0.0222. Now remember, you're going to have to do this every time you want an area to the right. The area on the graph is always going to give you something on the left-hand side. Okay, last piece here. In this case, we're looking for an area that actually lies in between two z-scores. Now we can only look them up one at a time. If I look up these z-scores in the table, for z equals negative 1.07, I'm going to be getting this little area over here. And then when I look up z equals 0.67, I'm going to be getting this area. So again, I really want you guys to draw these, sketch it out. If we want the area in between them, I'm going to take this bigger area and then subtract the littler area, right, to get the area in between. So we're going to try and take this little area, subtract it from what's over here, and find the area that we want. Okay, so look up both of these in the table, and then we're going to subtract them. Make sure that you're getting these same numbers from your table. So we're going to have 0.7486, that big area, minus the little area over on the left, and that difference will be our answer. All right, so we're getting an area of 0.6063. This would be our answer. Again, this really means that there's about 60% of the data falling in between these two values. Okay, we'd also like to be able to go the reverse direction. So if I know the area, I want to be able to find what z-score that corresponds to. So here, I'm going to be looking in the table for this area value, 0.75, and then finding what the z-score is. Now in this case, I'm expecting a z-score on the right-hand side. Why would that be? Well, 0.75 is more than 50%, so we're getting more than half on this left-hand side. So I'm going to look in my table for 0.75. I'm going to be looking in the positive z-score chart. And we're going to be scanning through all these numbers looking for 0.75. If you can't find 0.75, we just want to find the closest. So here's 0.7580. If I jump up to the next line, we've got a 0.7486, 0.7517. You can either figure out which of these is closer, or you could also take a number right in between. In this case, this one on the left here, 0.7486, is a little bit closer, so I'm going to take the z-score for this spot. Now this is the z-score 0.67, and that would be our answer. Next one, here we want to find the z-score where this area on the right here is 0.05. Now remember, our chart is only giving us areas to the left, so I don't want to look up 0.05 here. I want to look up what would be on this left-hand side. Now remember, the total is 1, so if I do 1 minus 0.05, I would get 0.95. So that means that the area to the left of this z-score is 0.95, and I can look that up. You'll notice that 0.95 is also not on here, but it does fall right in between these two. You'll see that there's actually a little star here. 0.95 is a very common number that we would want to look up, 95%. So they pull this out and say, oh, 0.95 area is actually equal to 1.645 as our z-score. So that would be our answer. Or if they only wanted two decimal places, we could round that to either 0.65 or possibly round down. All right, last one, 0.3050. This is an area to the left, which means it is what we're looking for in the table. Now notice that this is less than 50%, so we're expecting this z-score to be negative. It's on the left-hand side. So I'm going to look up 0.3050 in our negative z-score chart. So negative 0.3050, that's right here. This was a z-score of negative 0.51 would be coming from this column, and that would be our answer. Now most of the problems here are not going to show you a picture to start with, so you have to be able to draw your own picture. In this case, we want to find the percentage, right? This indicates an area, right? Our areas are our percentages or our probabilities. So we're finding the area, percentage of data values greater than z equals 1.82. So the first thing I'm going to do is sort of sketch in my little bell curve and say z equals 1.82. Where would that fall? Now this doesn't have to be exact, but I do want to know, is that going to be on the right, on the left? Is it going to be really far out or closer towards the center? This is a positive z-score, so remember zero's in the middle. I'm going to draw it right about here. Now in this case, we want to find the area corresponding to data values greater than this z-score. So the area we're interested in is this one right here. Now again, the one we're going to look up from the table is this one, and then we're going to have to adjust. So I'm looking up 1.82 in the table. This gives me an area of 0.9656. And this is the area to the left. For our area to the right, we're going to have to do 1 minus 0.9656. Gives me an area of 0.0344. Percentage-wise, this would be about 3.44 percent, meaning about 3.44% of the data would be above this z-score. Flipping this around, here they're asking us to find P5, which is the fifth percentile. So this is a z-score. We're trying to find the z-score here that separates the bottom 5% from the top 95%. So bottom 5% is sort of this left tail here, right? 5% down here, 95% up here. And we're trying to find the z-score, which means we need an area. Now we actually have two areas here, one corresponding to 5%, one corresponding to 95%. If I want to use the table though, I want to know this area. So 5% is going to be a decimal of 0.05. Our areas are always given as probabilities or as a number less than 1. So we're going to look up for an area of 0.05 and try and find the z-score. Now we're expecting a z-score with a negative here, so we're going to use the negative table. The z-score is also a special one, so you'll see it down at the bottom of the table, but it comes out to about negative 1.645, or if you said negative 1.65, that would probably be okay here too. Alright, here's some problems for you to try, and in the next video we'll look at how we can apply these ideas to solving more real-world problems.